We're back on the trail of a big governor's race. This week, it's the Republican primary in Illinois. All candidates focused on their enemy number one, incumbent J.B. Pritzker, all of them with very different experience. At the moment, four men officially launched campaigns. Illinois State Senator Darren Bailey, businessman Gary Rabin, former Illinois State Senator Paul Schimpf, and former police officer Christopher Roper. Follow the money, and you see three of them are more serious contenders. Filings with the Illinois State Board of Elections show Bailey with the most cash on hand at the end of the second quarter, with almost $500,000 in the bank. Rabin just shy of $300,000 himself. Schimpf has more than $100,000. Christopher Roper has less than $300 in campaign cash at the end of the second quarter. Now, we will get to know Paul Schimpf a little better this morning. He was born on Scott Air Force Base near Belleville, Illinois, and raised in Waterloo, Illinois, where he still calls home today. Schimpf graduated from the U.S. Naval Academy, earned a law degree from Southern Illinois University, served in the Marine Corps, and climbed the ranks to lieutenant colonel, actually deployed to Iraq in 2005, where he was the chief American advisor for the prosecution of Saddam Hussein. He retired from the military in 2013 after a 20-year career. Paul Schimpf is not new to politics. He worked on the staff of Minnesota Congressman John Klein. He ran for Illinois Attorney General in 2014 when he lost to incumbent Lisa Madigan. 2 years later, in 2016, Schimpf ran for the Illinois State Senate, a race that he won, representing parts of several counties in the southern part of the state, though Schimpf decided not to run for re-election in 2020. Another Republican since won his seat. Illinois' Republican primary race for governor is already somewhat crowded, and it could get more cramped in the months ahead. That doesn't deter the man we mentioned a moment ago. Former Illinois State Senator Paul Schimpf joins us for a conversation in his quest to be the next governor of Illinois. Thanks so much for being here, Senator.
Thanks for having me on.
Absolutely. Well, let's start with the political challenge of simply winning the primary. There are four candidates officially in the race so far. This field could get larger. People like Congressman Rodney Davis and Adam Kinzinger come up in conversations as well in this race as high-profile Republicans who could run. How do you distinguish yourself to win in a field that could be half a dozen or more?
Well, I think I'm the one that has the blueprint to actually defeat J.B. Pritzker and win this race. I think if you look at my background, the fact that I'm not a career politician, I spent my adult life in the Marine Corps, where you have to be able to work with people from across the political and social spectrum in order to be successful. The fact that I've also put forth a lot of ideas about how we can move our state in a different direction. And lastly, I'm the Republican candidate that has won a tier one political race against a Democrat. A tier one race is a race where both sides feel like they can win and they put a lot of resources in it. When I ran for the Illinois Senate in 2016, I ran against the former lieutenant governor of Illinois. We got outspent by over 300,000, but yet I won that race by almost 22 points. And that's because I talked about the issues that unite us, not the issues that divide us. And that's what we're doing in this governor campaign.
You talk about being outspent because another issue in all these races is money, a challenge you face. Right now, you rank third of the four candidates officially in the race in terms of money in the bank after the second quarter. Idealistically, money wouldn't be important, but in today's political environment, we do know it is. So what does it take for you to overcome that disadvantage?
Well, I think that we're getting a lot of good momentum. I think that we're on pace to probably raise a couple million dollars, I think, by the time we get to the end of the primary. And I think that's going to be enough to get our message out and win the primary. Now, as far as competing in the general election in Illinois, that's going to take millions of dollars. I think probably the minimum is about $50 million. I'm looking to some of our wealthy donors that once they see what a good campaign we've run, I'm willing to bet that they're going to make an investment in me and in our campaign, and I think we will have the money to compete.
Well, you'd have to assume whoever wins the primary will get certainly significant donations to compete at that point. How much does this race in Illinois, do you feel, a matter of party identity for the Republicans? What do you want to be the identity of your party?
Well, I want the Republican Party to stand for non-corrupt, responsible government, safe communities, and economic growth through the free market. I think that's what the Republican Party needs to stand for. I think the people of Illinois are ready for that. I think the people of Illinois are really frustrated with the same failed tactics that we've had all the time, bigger government, increased taxes, more government spending. They want a government that is going to be responsible, a government that is going to live within its means, have a little bit of fiscal restraint, and they also want a government that they can trust. I think that's something that I bring to the table. I served our country for 24 years. The people of the United States and the people of Illinois have trusted me. And then my record as a state senator is one where I kept my promises. I voted against all the tax increases that went across my desk. I think I can unite our state.
Let's say you win the primary and the general election to be the next governor of Illinois. I'm sure that's a scenario you'd like to see. You're very likely to be in a situation like the last Republican governor, Bruce Rauner, dealing with the legislature with a Democratic majority in both houses. Rauner seemed to take a my way or the highway approach. And what would be your approach? How can you get what you want done dealing with a Democratic majority?
Well, I think to make government work, you have to believe in coalition building. You have to believe in incrementalism. I have good working relationships with the leader of the Illinois House and the Illinois Senate. Speaker Welch and I worked together on the Illinois Higher Education Working Group back when I was in the Illinois Senate. And then President Harmon and I served on JCAR, the Joint Committee for Administrative Rules, together. I think you have to be able to work together. You have to be able to try to find solutions. And just because somebody disagrees with you politically, that does not make them the enemy. I think actually we need each other and our differences of opinion, our different political perspectives, if we're going to be able to solve the problems that our state faces. So I do think I will be able to work with the Democrats, although I'm hoping, you know, that it's going to be a wave election and that we're going to have Republicans in control.
Of course you do. Of course you do. We're just trying to hold, you know, reality in check. And that would be a pretty big tidal wave for sure.